आपको कम टाइम दे पा रहे हैं हम. इच्छा तो यही हो रही है कि आप बोलते रहे और हम सुनते रहे. और आपने हाँ सर, अब मेरी जिम्मेदारी मुझे ऐसी दी गई है ना, मैं क्या करूँ, इसलिए मुझे कहना पड़ा यहाँ से. अब हमारे दूसरे वक्ता हैं डॉक्टर जयंती बालाजी अथवले. ये महर्षि अध्यात्म विश्वविद्यालय गोवा से हैं. उनसे अनुरोध है कि वो आए. हाँ जी आइए.
वेदों का ज्ञान एवं वेदों की अनुभूति देने वाले गुरु परा गुरु परंपरा मेरे गुरुदेव डॉक्टर जयंत महाराज जी राठौले और वेदों के आप सभी विद्यार्थी और अनुयायी, आप सभी को पहले वंदन करता हूँ. ये जो प्रेजेंटेशन मैं करने वाला हूँ तो इसमें वेद में जो दो बातें बताई है, मतलब एक शत्रु को ढूंढना जो एक अंतर्गत है और एक बाह्य शत्रु है, और शत्रु एक स्थूल होता है और एक शत्रु सूक्ष्म होता है. और जब अंदर का शत्रु ज्यादा बुरा होता है, अगर वो शत्रु हमारा प्रत्यक्ष शत्रु अगर बुरा है तो वो जो डिस्ट्रक्शन कर सकता है, तो उसके लिए जो उपायों की जरूरत है वो सबसे ज्यादा वेदों में बताई है और वो हमें अभी सीखने की आवश्यकता है. मेरा प्रेजेंटेशन इंग्लिश में है तो मैं उसी में थोड़ा सा प्रयास करूंगा. नॉट मेनी ऑफ अस वुड कनेक्ट द वेदास विद द फ्रेज आर्ट ऑफ वॉर, एंड येट द हिंदू एपिक्स सच एज रामायण एंड महाभारत दे शो कोर्स द फियर्स बैटल वेयर सम इंटेंस वेपनरी वॉज यूज and the like of which have not been seen in today's day and age. The Sudarshan Chakra, Brahmastra, Brahma Shirshastra are weapons that surpass today's technologically advanced weaponry and were capable of much destruction as a nuclear device and even more. They were feared by even the most fierce opponent. Compared to how the rest of world fought wars, ancient Indian warfare actually took the concept of weaponry to the whole new level. And not only weaponry, the concept of enemy to a whole new level. Firstly, physical weapons known as Shastra could be made far more potent by using certain spiritual practices to elevate their potency, and they were known as Astras. To summon or use an astra required the warrior to have the spiritual knowledge of how to use a specific incantation, and the deity invoked would then endow the weapon, making it impossible to counter through regular means. Spiritual power took precedence over the physical weapon. A case in point is when Ashwatthama, the son of Dronacharya, in the battle in the Mahabharata, invoked the powerful Brahma Shirsha Astra by merely using a blade of grass as his weapon. Astras, when released, could find their target not only in the earth but out in the other lokas or subtle planes of existence of spiritual dimensions like hell or nether regions. Imagine trying to use any modern day missile to kill a demonic entity in the spiritual dimension. The vidya or knowledge of these powerful astras in the art of war were imparted by the guru to deserving disciples, and the knowledge was treated with the utmost reverence. In fact, the warrior was also taught how to revoke an astra once it is launched. There was an etiquette on the battlefield between the warriors. which you will not find in today's world. For example, there are instances where sages have intervened and asked warriors to revoke their astras, as it would inhalate large area of lands, people and resources, and the warrior would obey with reverence. But perhaps the most marked difference in the war in earlier eras, such as Treta Yuga and Dwapar Yuga, they were not fought for just some ideological purpose or material gain. Wars were fought only as a last resort by forces of righteousness against forces of unrighteousness, so as to eradicate evil kings on earth or demons from the spiritual dimensions who were troubling society. A case in point, Lord Rama attacking Ravana only after all diplomatic efforts to reason with him to return Sita had failed. In fact, a key focus of the Atharva Veda is providing mantras for a subtle battle on how to overcome attacks by negative energies, which are unseen subtle enemies from the spiritual dimension. You can see on the slides also. The basis of Indian culture unfortunately has been eroded, and now the very people in the position of power, instead of being the guardian of the righteousness in the country, are often corrupt and they themselves trouble society. It has been our experience that in current era, mankind is also heavily influenced by negative energies from the spiritual dimensions, which make people behave less than humans. And that is the basic cause for unrest and war. We have to understand it. Now, all many seems very far-fetched to the modern generation who may consider it pure mythology. But was this art real? Were mantras able to protect and counter-attack negative energies? And have we lost this art over the centuries to protect humanity from the negative forces? I represent the Maharshi Adhyatma Vishwavidyalay in Goa, India, founded by His Holiness Dr. Jayant, a clinical hypnotherapist by profession, and the university specializes in conducting research into how the spiritual dimension and spiritual vibrations affects our lives. We have had first-hand experience in the concept of a subtle battle or a subtle war. It all started over 2 decades ago. After a few years, some of our seekers who have started practicing spirituality under the guidance of His Holiness Dr. Athavale started to display some very strange behavior. You can see on the video, the behavior would erupt quite spontaneously, especially during Aarti ritual and also during group chanting sessions. Aarti is a ritual of waving a lit lamp in front of deities or saints, accompanied by singing of devotional hymns. Tests conducted by in-house psychiatrists conclude that there was nothing psychologically wrong with this group of seekers. Witnessing such phenomena on such a large scale could be quite shocking and even frightening, especially to a newcomer. By undertaking spiritual research into the case of this unusual and strange behavior through the medium of an advanced sixth sense of spiritual research team, it was found that these seekers were affected and possessed by negative energies. Negative energies are subtle entities from the spiritual dimension that harms the humanity at the physical, psychological and spiritual level. Unless we won't understand the concept of adhi bhautik, adhi daivik, adhi adhyatmik karana of problems in subjective and in society, we can't have a proper solution for peace and attaining bliss. So the next question in front of us was that why were we as an organization being singled out? Were we doing something wrong? And the answer we got from the higher level of sense was that it was actually a reflection of what we were doing right. Because the negative energies possessing some of the seekers could not tolerate the positivity of the spiritual practice, and hence they were manifesting. So in fact, the manifestation were like a backhanded compliment from negative energies about the potency and positivity of the spiritual practice. It soon dawned on us that we had inadvertently found ourselves right in the middle of an intense subtle battle in the modern era. And so, a new phase of our spiritual research began out of necessity which is how to contract and rid oneself of negative energies, which is learning the art of war against a more powerful and subtle enemy. Today I am here to share some of our findings learned over two decades. Now I am sharing some of my findings like that. Negative energies often manifest if they cannot tolerate spiritual positivity. Any manifestation usually weakens them. Apart from the seekers themselves being attacked, you can see the object used by the seekers were also attacked by the subtle level, and these are some of the example of the item that change spontaneously without any apparent cause. In a subtle battle, spiritual strength is far greater than physical strength, as even a physical strong person can easily succumb to a spiritual attack. The battlefield is often our mind, as our personality defects such as anger, greed, jealousy, prejudice are used by negative energies to control us. This is very much important point, that why we face external wars, why there is unrest in the society, and with one reference how Sri Aurobindo contract with Hitler in Second World War is a really interesting thing to understand. Access to higher levels of spiritual power increases as per one spiritual level. When we look at the level of power in the universe, physical power is at the lowest level. After that come mantra plus some physical activity, and later only mantra. Finally, the highest level of powers are wielded by saint of highest level by their resolve or just by their presence. This is the keynote of Vedas and spirituality. If you attend the spiritual power to resolve or your presence affect the society with positivity, then in really we can say that Bharat is Vishwaguru or Bharat can guide the universe. Lastly, I would like to add a word of caution. Just as in ancient times, intense spiritual battle, as we have seen, are usually precursor to intense physical battle on earth. And these two are usually instigated by negative energies. While higher level sages warn of very difficult time ahead of humanity in terms of imminent Third World War, the comforting thought is that the principle of spiritual protection still remains the same, which is spiritual practice and spiritual healing. Actually, हम बार बार देखते हैं कि महाभारत रामायण हुआ, मगर जो स्थूल में चल रहा था उससे ज्यादा जो सूक्ष्म में चल रहा था उसका परिणाम ज्यादा था. सबसे अंत में जब कृष्ण जब उस रथ से उतरे और उसके बाद जो परिणाम पांडवों ने अनुभव किया था, जो अभी हम अनुभव नहीं कर सकते, उसके बारे में हमें चिंतन करने की आवश्यकता है. नाउ वी हैव डेवलप्ड सम टूल्स टू फाइट नेगेटिविटी एंड इन अ वे chanting is one of the best remedy to have protection from negative energies. We have seekers in our spiritual research team who can actually perceive the vibrations emitted by people and objects. By drawing them, they serve as a spiritual x-rays and provide clarity about the true nature behind the cause of event. Now you can see the subtle picture that shows the positive energies that get generated around a person when they chant name of their deity. Along with chanting Sri Gurudev Datta at least for 2 hours a day, they help us to protect against problem caused by departed ancestors also. When negative energy attack a person, they use something known as black energy, which is spiritual form of energy used by these subtle entities for harming people. One technique of healing is to drain out or reduce the black energy covering that they put on us. We have found the rock salt is a potent natural substance that helps in this process. By adding merely 2 tablespoons of rock salt to a bucket of water and then immersing 1 foot in it, it helps to suck out the black energy. So simple yet so powerful. Now next, we use an instrument known as UTS to study the subtle effects of 15 minutes of salt water remedy on a person who is suffering from attacks by negative energy. The UTS is an instrument developed by Dr. Manav Murthy, a former nuclear scientist from India. It is used to measure the subtle energy, both positive and negative, and the aura around the object that is living and non-living. And the reading showed that his negative aura was eliminated completely after doing salt water remedy. Like this, we have provided various spiritual healing remedies on our website, which act as a countermeasures to a spiritual attack, and they are free of cost. For spiritually cleansing the environment and spiritually pure people who are able to imbibe the positivity, we have found that performing yajnas or sacrificial fires where Sanskrit mantras are recited are very powerful spiritual tools that are like weapons against negative energies. The potency of yajna depends on various factors such as resolve, that is sankalpa of the saint who blessed it, the spiritual emotion of the priest performing it exactly as it is meant to be, the positivity of the premises it is conducted in, the spiritual practice of the attendees and etc. Now here you can see the yajna performing in our ashrama. So when we took reading through this UTS scanner, we found the positive aura of the presiding saint double from 33 meters to an astonishing 66 meter, while her total measured aura increased from 35 to 74 meters. The same positive effect was seen on the auras of the seekers attending the yajna. Such positive effects on the person's aura increases their spiritual protection significantly from such an attack. It is a subtle picture of what a yajna looks like in the subtle and the effect it has on the people and the environment. We have found that the positive spiritual effect of yajna can last for many months, if not years. And lastly, concluding, I would like to say that seekers who diligently practice spirituality and make sincere efforts to grow spiritually obtain divine protection that saves their life not only from subtle attacks but even in the large event of large-scale natural disasters and nuclear third world war. This is the power of that spiritual practice provides. So, to prevent, to avoid external war, or to protect from such disasters and external war, a spiritual practice is a must for every person. Thanking you. Namaskar.